Hello, I am Dr. François Ventura. I am an anesthesiologist, I am an intensive care physician and emergency medical doctor. I am working in Geneva, Switzerland at the University Hospital in the Department of Anesthesiology and in a private clinic working in the Department of the ICU. And my topics today will be current research on early sepsis biomarker. As you know, for sepsis, we must have infection plus inflammation and plus organ dysfunction. For the diagnosis of infection, there is no biomarker recommended in 2023. Even PCT is not recommended. And the recommendation is to have just clinical evaluation. And this is the best practice statement for infection. And for inflammation, there is no biomarker. Even CRP is a good biomarker, but CRP is not recommended. And once again, this is only clinical score and the CIS-92 score, which is recommended for the diagnosis of inflammation. And for organ dysfunction, once again, this is clinical score, MUSE, or SOFA score, but no biomarker are recommended. And lactate is not recommended for the diagnosis of organ dysfunction. So as I told you, there is no biomarker recommended nowadays, but the use of clinical evaluation as recommended had a bad specificity. And we know that if we are going to use only clinical evaluation, 70% of the time we are going to give antibiotics for no good reason. And another reason maybe to use biomarker is that clinicians are using more biomarkers than clinical score. This is a survey we did in Switzerland, in my country, and this study shows that about 100 of my colleagues were using biomarker and only less than half of my colleagues were using clinical score. So maybe biomarker could be useful. And the question is, are we going to use a biomarker just for infection, just for inflammation, just for organ dysfunction, or maybe a biomarker for the overall for sepsis? So maybe there will be 1, 2, 3, or even 4 different biomarkers for the different items of sepsis. In 2009, there was a study publishing that a biomarker of sepsis must have maybe 5 different purposes. The first one will be screening. It means early a pre-symptomatic diagnosis of sepsis, of nosocomial sepsis. Second purpose will be diagnostic. It means quick rule in or rule out sepsis at time of clinical suspicion. The third one will be monitoring, to monitor the treatment efficacy, for example, and for the de-escalation of antibiotics. The fourth one will be risk stratification to predict evolution. And the fifth one will be surrogate endpoint to predict outcome and mortality. And maybe the two last, the fourth and the fifth purpose, are not so useful in the clinical practice because we are not going to stop treatment. For example, if a biomarker is saying that the mortality rate at 28 days will be very high. So there is 5 different purposes for a biomarker. As I told you before, maybe we will need 4 different biomarker for the 4 different parameters of sepsis. It means sepsis, inflammation, infection, and organ dysfunction. So maybe in total we will have 20 different biomarker, and we can see on that table the 4 different conditions that biomarker could be diagnosed: infection, inflammation, organ dysfunction, sepsis, and the 5th purposes. So maybe there will be 1 biomarker we are going to fit the 20 condition, or maybe 20 different biomarker for the 20 different items. And we'll see the answer during this talk. Early mean pre-symptomatic diagnosis of nosocomial sepsis. It means to detect sepsis even before symptoms to patients at high risk of nosocomial infection, and for patients, of course, already hospitalized. And for that kind of testing, we need a biomarker with a very good sensitivity and a very good positive predictive value. And not to confound early and quick, and quick diagnosis means at time of clinical suspicion, to quickly confirm or rule in or rule out sepsis. And we have 45 to 60 minutes to do this. And we need that test to decide to give or not to give antibiotics. And this is the question. And for these purposes, we need a biomarker with a very good specificity and negative predictive value. So not the same than for the early diagnosis of presymptomatic nosocomial sepsis. Another study published in 2010 say that the biomarker of sepsis must meet some criteria, and this is the assured criteria. It means affordable, not too expensive, and maybe less than the price of antibiotics. The test must be sensitive with a very good positive predictive value for the early pre-symptomatic diagnosis of nosocomial sepsis, specific with a good negative predictive value to rule in or rule out sepsis at time of clinical suspicion, user-friendly, probably a POCT of point of care testing, rapid, less than 45 to 60 minutes for sure, equipment-free. I think it will be difficult, but the simple equipment is possible. And we add two other parameters, not including in the ASU criteria, but for pediatrics, we need a small sample of blood. And of course, the test must be certified in Europe, in the US, and maybe in other countries as well. That's why we published in March this year a table to tick the box of all these parameters for an ideal sepsis biomarker. There is a study published in 2010 saying that there was already 178 different sepsis biomarkers on different studies on these different biomarkers. 20 years later, in 2020, there is 258 different sepsis biomarkers. Of course, there is classical biomarker that everybody knows, like CRP, PCT, like that. There is some new biomarker of sepsis, like interleukin-6, pre-sepsin, pancreatic stone protein, and so on. And this is very important to know that there is 9 biomarkers that are better than CRP and PCT. But the problem is that most of these biomarkers are not very well studied, and there is not a lot of study for these different new biomarkers. And we have done a PubMed search last month showing that there was already more than 12,000 studies on different biomarkers of sepsis. And just for this year, there was already about 300 studies on sepsis biomarkers. So the research is huge. And if you are going to see the different kind of biomarkers of sepsis, there is a huge list of different biomarker depending on the pathophysiology of sepsis. I have, of course, no time to go in details or to all these biomarkers. Yes, I'm going to present you an example of PSP, maybe combined with CRP. PSP is pancreatic stone protein. PSP is a damage-associated molecular patterns. There is already more than 600 peer-reviewed studies, about 46 peer-reviewed studies on PSP and sepsis. There is already a prospective multicentric study, a meta-analysis, literature review. PSP is certified in Europe, in Australia, and soon in the US at the end of this year. And PSP could be tested in less than 10 minutes, in 7 minutes with a POCT and with a small sample of whole blood. PSP could be used for the early diagnosis of sepsis and even for the quick diagnosis. First of all, I'm starting with the early diagnosis, means before symptom for pre-symptomatic nosocomial sepsis diagnosed. This is a study published 2 to 3 years ago in 2020 by the team of the University Hospital of Zurich in a burn center. This is 90 burn patients. And you know that that kind of patients are at high risk of nosocomial infection and sepsis. And they test the biomarker every day. For example, in the left side, we have CRP. And what we can see, that CRP is increasing, but after the event, after the sepsis, after septic shock, or after infection. For the leukocyte, there is no big variation of leukocyte at time of event, infection, sepsis, or septic shock. For PCT, PCT is increasing, but at the day of the event. So when clinical suspicion is already obvious, PCT is increasing. But the big difference with pancreatic stone protein is that PSP is increasing already 2 to 3 days before the event and even before symptoms. And this is this concept of pre-symptomatic diagnosis of nosocomial infection. And based on that study, a multicentric study was done in Europe, in France, Italy, UK, and Switzerland. And this study, 250 patients admitted in the ICU for different purposes. And this study shows that PSP is increasing 3 to 5 days before symptoms in patients who are going to develop sepsis. And this is not the case with PCT and not the case with CRP as well. And we can see in that graph that the standard deviation is not overlapping for PSP and is not the case for PCT and for CRP. That's why we propose to daily monitoring PSP to patients admitted in the intensive care unit to detect in advance and before symptoms nosocomial sepsis and infection. For the quick diagnosis at time of clinical suspicion, different studies show that the combination of PSP and CRP has the best accuracy to detect or to confirm or to rule out infection and sepsis. That's why we propose to include biomarker like PSP and CRP beside the clinical evaluation in the Sepsis 3 definition. As I showed you before, this table with the 20 possibilities of biomarker, I think that the use of biomarker for inflammation or organ dysfunction is not really useful in daily practice. And it is the same for risk stratification or surrogate endpoint. So maybe we will need only 6 biomarkers for infection and sepsis for screening, diagnosis, and monitoring. And if we summarize the research nowadays, we can propose to use PSP for screening infection, to use PSP and CRP to quick diagnosis of sepsis and infection, and to use PCT for monitoring treatment and to decide to de-escalate or to stop antibiotics. As I told you before, there is no biomarker currently recommended. So future research should specify what type of use would like to study for the biomarker and what will be the intended for use. We have to apply a standardized protocol to answer clinical questions because many studies were done with no real clinical question. We don't have to compare the new biomarker to the old biomarker like leukocyte, CRP, PCT, like that because these biomarkers are not recommended. So the study must be designed to detect if the new biomarker are able to detect sepsis, infection, or to decide to treat or not with antibiotics, but not to compare new biomarker with old biomarker who are not recommended. A future biomarker must be assured, and it means this criteria, and must be certified for sure. Now, the combination of biomarker and maybe a clinical pretest probability score will be probably the current missing tool. And maybe we could integrate all this into a machine learning system. I think that the combination of PSP and CRP could be very interesting nowadays. And as I told you before, the use of PSP by daily monitoring could be useful for the early diagnosis of pre-symptomatic nosocomial sepsis. The use of PSP combined with CRP has the best accuracy to detect sepsis at time of clinical suspicion. PSP, there is already more than 45 studies. There is more than 20 international studies ongoing. And I think that PSP combined with CRP fulfill the ideal criteria for sepsis biomarker on the table we propose in an article published in March 2023. Thank you for your attention.